This is Chad Oliver on scene live with the banner. We're here at the Dialysis Center here in Princeton, Kentucky, and it's currently, of course, on fire right now.
Of course, I believe the cops, the sheriffs, are all here right now. Of course, the fire department is here. As you can see, it's a pretty big fire. It's pretty well engulfed. And we will try to get some words with some of the officials when we can, if we can. I'm standing right across the street on South Jefferson, right across from the Dialysis Center, and you can feel the heat. I know there was reports of explosions. I don't know if you guys can see inside the doorway there where the fire has engulfed completely inside. Thank you. flames on the roof. I don't know if you guys can see it as well as I can, I'm sure, from where I'm at. Really seems as if it's beginning to get a little bit under control now. There's still lots of smoke in this area. If you can, avoid the North Jefferson, South Jefferson area. There's plenty of smoke out towards this way in front of Circle K, in front of Fireless Realty. We're going to take a walk onto the other side. How are you, sir?
Lord Murdoch and I try to get together with you one day and talk about the airport.
I'm happy
about it. You know, Lord, of course, he lost his home completely, and they've been staying in an apartment, and they finally found a place a little more permanent, and they're trying to get moved into that just settled. So, you know, I don't want to bother too much right now about it, but we'd certainly like to get, you know, more about the airport out there.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
So,
anytime you're looking at it.
Talk to him about it, and he wants to do it, but at the same time, you know, I told him he got back to his house. I went to Princeton last week. Last Thursday was Aviation and Aerospace Day at the Capitol, and I went up on Wednesday and went to the Texas Aviation Caucus on Wednesday night, talked to a lot of legislators about the airport, and then went to the Capitol, and that was Princeton on Thursday. And, you know, we got good response, but we need a lot of help from that's the biggest economic development tool we got in the county. And so what the women, people may not understand is when you're paying any size, they can't take the time to drive in here. They're going to fly in because they can go to two or three different sites in a day's time. So it's just... My daughter takes care of those buildings over there. But Dan, somebody called her and told her they're in the problem.
Can't fight it very much in this wind.
No, you can't. Of course, it looks to be a total loss. Of course, we hope there's no foul play involved. We're going to try to ease on over here a little bit. Try to walk around to the other side now. Good, how are you? Of course, you guys can just see the smoke. It's just, can't see anything on this side. which you can see from this side, it's Princeton has seen its share of destruction over the past few months. We're going to stay live with this as long as we can. We're at the back side of the dialysis center right now. See Fire Chief Brent Francis. And we'll try to get a word with him when we can. Dakota Young. You can see the gas meter right there. Yeah, I'm sure that's where the explosions from earlier. see. She heard that explosion go off right there. Renee Hinckley, I believe it was still in use. Thank you. try walking back around to the other side now. Marianne, I believe you're right, it was the gas meter. And I believe it was probably just the gas that was left in the line, but it seems to be put out right now. Of course, as you can see, it's a total loss. All right, guys, we're going to take a break. It seems like the fire is pretty well under control. And we'll try to be back live here in just a bit, and hopefully we can get an interview with Fire Chief Brent Francis. And see if they know exactly where it started and what time it started. So guys, we'll be back with you shortly.